Just sound it off. Gives you ideas you can. Just sound it off. Gives others ideas they can. Sound it off.
"24 Hours in London, the coolest gangster movie since Reservoir Dogs? Let's discuss." This one was originally known as 24 Little Hours and is written and directed by Paul Knight. And this one's actually being released in early 2020. So this is a British crime caper that has a interesting kind of framing device. Essentially what we have this policewoman who is conducting an investigation about this guy who was recently kind of released from prison and seemed to be going on a bit of a killing spree. And essentially what you have here, you have this woman interviewing a variety of kind of witnesses and people who are connected to a series of criminal events. And then we kind of, as the kind of the film kind of goes along, these people are essentially telling their story, and then we see these kind of as vignettes through the movie. So we get, you know, kind of essentially two parallel stories. We get the actual story about this guy who has been in prison for 10 years. He's come out, he wants revenge because his sister was murdered, and he kind of hooks up with some criminal buddies to go on a series of kind of violent battles with kind of rival gangsters, and this ends up in kind of like, you know, turf wars and things like this, and all the while seeking kind of revenge for the death of his sister. And then we have this policeman who is trying to kind of figure out the mess that he's leaving behind, getting pressure from kind of her superior and trying to kind of follow the clues. And she's kind of been disgraced before when she made the department look bad at some point in the kind of the past. And obviously these kind of two converging kind of storylines will culminate. Well, I say they'll culminate. These two never actually kind of meet up at any point, but nonetheless these stories will kind of converge and obviously come to a conclusion. So what do we think of this movie? So this is a very stylish, hyper cool, violent gangster flick that is clearly influenced by the likes of Tarantino and Guy Ritchie, I would say. The way this kind of this story is kind of broken up with this kind of framing device is obviously a strong directorial choice here. And I've got to say, this movie absolutely looks super stylish. It has an amazing soundtrack. The soundtrack here really kind of elevates this kind of material into the kind of like the uber cool, kind of almost like hyper reality that we'll kind of see. These kind of like gangster fantasies that you kind of see in Grand Theft Auto and stuff like this. So it's kind of not a particularly realistic look, but it's obviously a highly stylized kind of like, you know, action crime caper. I've got to say, there are, so for a relatively kind of low budget, I feel this movie's very ambitious. Obviously, there's the way the story is told narratively is not kind of straight kind of A to B. It's kind of broken up with this kind of this like the framing device. We'll kind of see things from sometimes kind of not in the same order and things like that. So, you know, it does have some ambition in storytelling and in kind of directorial style. And obviously, that's kind of down to the director Paul Knight here. There are some kind of standout moments. So there's kind of like a raid in a kind of a warehouse where these guys are kind of donning paintball masks and they kind of look very effective. And there's even quite a little bit of kind of the comedy here, which I think is quite fun. And we have some kind of fun and interesting characters. Some of these kind of these gangster characters, they're very much played to kind of stereotypes, but nonetheless, I kind of enjoyed some of their kind of like their camaraderie and the kind of the way they are. There's a little bit of banter between them. So the dialogue sometimes is, you know, is kind of quite fun. Maybe what doesn't work here, I don't think the narrative flow is quite as strong as the director thinks that it is. So when we kind of compare this to, like I've said, directors like Guy Ritchie and Tarantino and Matthew Vaughn to a degree, these are very established directors who have got a strong directorial style, and I feel that the director and writer here, Paul Knight, definitely has seen these guys as an influence and has tried to kind of do a similar style, but I don't think he's entirely successful here, as I feel the actual story, the narrative within this kind of framing device gets completely, well, not completely lost, it does get somewhat lost in the way that it's told. You end up kind of getting a little bit kind of like perplexed about what is kind of going on. Part of this, I feel, is there's no real central protagonist. Now, I've mentioned, it sounds as I described the story there, that the kind of the movie focuses on this guy that he's let out of prison. And I think the movie is supposed to be like that. But he doesn't have a huge amount of screen time compared to some other characters. I mean, to be honest with you, the character that you see the most of is actually probably this policeman who is interviewing kind of people. The other thing is that our main kind of character, if you like, this guy who's released from prison. I mean, to be fair, he doesn't really look. He looks like he's more like a catalogue model than someone who's been inside for 10 years, I must say. But the decision was made to not have him speak at all, and that's obviously a choice made by the director. It's not that he can't speak; he just doesn't in the movie until right at the end. That's really just for a gag. And all of this kind of like him not speaking is for this one gag at the end. However, this has a serious ramification on the film, because we feel like we don't know this person. Because he doesn't speak, there is no sense of connect between the audience and us, and the audience and the film. So we never really feel like we get to know this character, and therefore are less invested in his journey. And he doesn't. And adding to this, like I've said, he doesn't. I don't feel like he had that much kind of screen time. So we have a character who, if he is going to be the kind of central protagonist, doesn't appear on screen as much as I would have thought he would have done. And when he is, he doesn't say anything. So it is hard to really get invested in a character that is just a kind of like a shell of a person, because we just don't know anything about them. And that was obviously a choice. But I don't feel it's the correct one. Again, I would just reiterate the fact that I feel the storytelling narrative with this kind of framing device doesn't completely work. It's a little confused. And then the other final thing I'll kind of say with this movie that I feel is a little bit of a critique is I feel some of the acting seems a little strained. In particular, the scenes in the police interview room. And it's not with everyone, but there are certain instances where the characters literally feel like they're reading from a script rather than it being kind of natural dialogue. I feel the dialogue is just kind of being delivered word for word like it's being read from a script rather than it sounding like an actual conversation. And as such, the dialogue here seems, and the acting seems very stilted in certain scenes. And there are instances in the kind of like the gangster sort of side of stuff as well, where it seems a little bit kind of here and there. So overall, I feel this movie has some strong directorial flourishes. It has some elements here that do make it a cool and fun kind of gangster flick, an action, hyper-realistic kind of fun romp, I suppose. But it's a little bit of a muddled mess with no clear central protagonist to follow, and therefore you're not as invested as I feel like the movie thinks you should be. And I think this is probably the biggest issue here. So I only give this one a 5 out of 10, and I feel this falls really just into the straight to DVD fare of kind of films. Although I feel there are some flourishes here, the experience is maybe lacking, which I feel is why this movie kind of ends up just being more or less a kind of like more forgettable, although not a bad movie. So 5 out of 10 for me. Have you seen it? What did you think of it? Leave me a comment and I'll look forward to seeing you next time. Bye for now.